rescue. $580.
Really? And a lot of them are with volunteer families that...
Right, except for about four that are in a kennel, they're all in foster homes.
So he was just one of those people that said he would take some of the animals. So then, after he would take some of the animals, would he physically sell those animals, or what would he do with the animals that he got?
Well, we're there in the adoption process, that we would receive the application on our website, and Petfinder was the other one. And we would process the applications and go through a thing of doing a vet reference, doing a home visit, and then going through with a contract and adopting the dog out. He wasn't really part of that too much, because he was new, we had more experienced people doing it. So he gained my trust that way, we're doing everything the right way at the beginning. He would bring the dogs to our vet, so they'd get better there, and then he would take them home, so...
So it took him a while before he started to kind of show his true color?
Yeah.
So obviously, if you're running an organizational field, you're going to have a relationship with the people that...
Yeah.
So essentially, what was he doing then with the animals that he would get from you, I guess?
He would just care for them until we would let them know we had interested parties to meet the dogs, and then we would, if it was a good match, then we'd go through with an adoption or a contract. Well, then after, then he started looking bad, or didn't notice it right away, he had a litter of puppies plus some adults, and he claimed they were sick, and they couldn't be adopted for 30 days, because he had to have them quarantined. Well, I started thinking about that, and what I did was, we had some applications on some of the dogs that he had in his possession, so we called these people and found out that he had adopted dogs out to them, asking for cash only, and not doing a contract, he was just taking cash. And a couple of instances where they didn't have cash, he wrote, had them write a check out to him in his name. And even on two of the checks, at the bottom on the comment line, it says the last day dog rescue. And that was really kind of stupid of him, because I have copies of those checks. And when I confronted him about it, he hung up on me and wouldn't deal with me. So then I went, and I was looking online at Olivia's Pet Resort, and three other dogs that were missing were on her website. So I called back.